Welcome to our DevNet class. So today we will be demonstrating the packet tracer as well as the use of the Python command. So let's start with the network scenarios. Okay, so I have here created a activity. Okay, let's open activity. So this is an extract activity. Of course, first, this will be the network scenario. So as you can see, we have a three network devices. Four network devices. We have switches and routers. We have a host devices, three PC, of course, network controller, as well as the DNS server. So this will be our addressing for this activity. Okay, the requirements. For our objectives, to configure basic router and switch configuration, implement server services and network controllers, as well as to demonstrate Python script to capture host and network device on a packet tracer active port. Okay. For the requirement for the switches and router, so we will be placing host name, create a username and password, as well as the domain name of Cisco, the crypto key, virtual terminal lines, as well as a privileged password. Okay, we will be using OSPF as a routing protocols. Okay, enable the services. Then we will be capturing the service ticket inside the packet tracer. Okay, we will getting the API code as well as use API to gather information around of the network around the packet tracer. This will be the code. Okay, ensure that you already have a Python as well as to install the request. Okay, for the activity for the student. Okay, the outcome of the student is that they will know, or they will know to configure router and switch. Okay, basic router and switch configuration, as well as to screenshot the output of the script. Okay, let's open a packet tracer. Okay, we have here a packet tracer. How about the version? I'm using the version 8.0. Okay. Next is we need to place a computer. So we are using PC1, 2, then we have a netted controller here, then place a PC here, okay, and a server for the DNS. Then moving, let's place two router peer-to-peer, okay, for the routing protocols of the OSPF. Then place switch, okay, let me use the 2960 switch. Okay, there you go. Okay, next is wiring, of course. If we are using unlike devices, we will be using straight through. Okay, straight through. Let's place pass Ethernet 1 to pass Ethernet, and pass Ethernet 0 to pass Ethernet 2. Okay. Next is for the network controller. Let's use the gigabit 00. Place it on the gigabit 02. Okay. Then for the switch to router, let's place it on gigabit to gigabit 0. Okay. On the other side, okay, we'll be using straight through again for the server. Let's place it on the gigabit 02. For the PC, pass Ethernet to pass Ethernet. Then for the switch, gigabit Ethernet to router 00. Okay. Is we're using peer-to-peer. Okay, crossover. Okay, there you go. So what are the requirements? We will place here a network 10.10.10.0. okay, peer-to-peer slash 30. We'll placing 192.168.10.0 here slash 24 network, and the network here will be 172.16.10.0. 0/24, okay, for the prefix lens. Let's place this as a dot 1 PC, then a dot 2. How about the controller? Let's make it 250. Okay. Okay. How about the server here? Let's place that 250. Let's make this as the second in line of second highest. The highest will be on the router. 5.4 for the router and for the switch 2.5.3 for the peer-to-peer dot 1 and dot 2. Okay. Next is let's place address based from the requirement 192.168.10.1, okay, with prefix step /24. How about the gateway? 192.168.10.254. Let's make use the DNS under 172.16.10.250. Okay. Next, on the PC 1, let's place 192.168.10.2. Gateway 192.168.10.54 and same DNS 172.16.10.250. Okay, ready done here. Let's move on the network controller. Okay, under G00. Okay, let's place 192.168.10.250. Okay, the subnet mask. Then setting, let's place a router 168.10.254. Okay, please. Okay, this is 172.16.10.250. Okay. Okay. Well, that's same configuration. Let's say this is activity 1. Okay. Save. Okay. Since we already have saved activity 1, next is how about this one? Server. Oh, okay. When you are using network controller, make sure that on your preferences and miscellaneous, to enable this one. Okay. Okay. Let's play a password here. How about Cisco? Okay. Under the controller, ensure that this is enabled for packet. Will be available under the local host. Okay, next server. Let's place an IP address. This is 172.16.10.250. Okay. That is 2550. Gateway will be 172.16.10.254, the highest. The server itself. 7001. Okay. Next is under services. Let's turn on the HTTP and the DNS. Okay. Let's turn on the services. Let's make this Cisco.com example. And we want to tell that will be the server. Same IP. Add. Okay. Turn on. Okay. Next is the desktop. 172.16.10.1. Okay. Next subnet mask 255.0. Okay. Next is the gateway. Okay. it's the gateway 172.16.10.254. Okay. Let's place the DNS 10.250. Okay. That's good. Next, we want to test if it's communicating 172.16.10.250. Okay, it's now replying from PC2 to server about this one. Let's test if the three devices are connected. That 2. Okay. About 250. Okay. Good. Next, based from the requirement. It says that we need to configure the domain name, create a user and a password, then we need to create modules for the crypto for the virtual terminal lines, and then we will be using, or we will be implementing it on the virtual terminal line. So I already prepared a code here so that we can speed up the process. Okay, if we are using switch, we need to key in this on the privilege mode. So let's name it a switch 1. Then, okay, this command will move on to the global configuration. We will change it to switch 1 hostname, then creating a user and password, the domain name, the encryption, then privilege password. We will implement it on the virtual terminal lines. Okay, let's copy this. Control C. Then move on the command line interface. Okay, table. Let's paste it here. Paste. As you can see, we have already configured the switch 1. How about the switch 2? Okay. Switch 2, table. Then we need to change this as a switch 2. Let's copy it. Moving the switch 2, paste. Okay. For the router, then table. Okay. Let's do this. For the router, let's make this as an R1. After 1024, that will be simultaneous user. So let's implement it on a router. Based. There you go. We have a router 1. How about on the router 2? Okay. No. Enable. Change the name to router 2. An IP address for this. Okay. Move on interface. Switch virtual interface or VLAN 1. Let's place an IP address. IP address 192.168.10.253 next to the router. 255.255.255.0. Okay. Turn on the interface by typing no shutdown. Then going back to global configuration, then let's place the router as a default gateway 192.168.10.254. Okay, let's save the configuration, do copy, run, start, since we are using the global configuration. Okay. We are already done here, so can ping now to ping 192.168.10.1 example. Okay, from switch virtual interface to PC. Oh, we have a mistake here, as you can see. We have a mistake on placing IP address VLAN 1. Let's correct it. Okay, IP address 192.168.10.253.255.255.0. Okay, exit. Can we now ping? Yes, success. Okay, let's save it. Do copy run start. Okay, config to startup configuration. Okay, how about on the switch to interface VLAN 1 for switch virtual interface? Place an IP address 172.16.10.253.255.255.255.0. Okay, no shutdown. Okay, then exit. Let's place a default gateway. Okay, 172.16.10.254. Highest IP address, then save the configuration. Do copy running config to startup configuration. Okay, I'll be ready through here. Okay, let's move on the router. Okay, under the router we have the G000. Let's place an IP address. Okay, that is the 192.168.254.net. Interface address 255.255.255.0. Okay, then no shutdown to turn on the interface. Let's move on to the G0/0/2. Okay, let's place an IP address 10.10.10.1 with 255.255.255.252 for the peer-to-peer under prefix length of /30. No shutdown to turn on the interface. Then exit. Then save to configuration. Do copy running config to startup configuration. Okay. About the other router, the router 2. Interface G0/0/0. For the remote host, then let's place an IP address of 172.16.10.54 with a subnet mask of 255.255.0. Turn on the interface by placing no shutdown. Then let's move on the G0/0/1 for the peer-to-peer IP address 10.10.10.2. Then we need to place 255.255.255.252. Okay, no shutdown. Okay, exit. Then do copy run start. Let's test if the router can ping. Mistake here. G001, then G01. We have forgot to turn on. Okay, we have mistaken the place on the G02. Okay, interface G0/0/2. Okay, let's shut down it. IP address. Okay. Then interface G0/0/1. IP address. That is 10.10.10.1. 255.255.255.252. No shutdown to turn on the interface. Then exit. Okay, we we have already have by green lights. Using router 1, then I ping now the 10.10.10.2. Okay, I forgot to press the 2 since I am using global configuration. Okay, there is success. How about the remote network from router 2? Okay, from router 1 here, can I ping the PC2 here? Okay, 172.16.10.1. Okay, time out. Why? Because we have not yet configured the routing protocol. So let's make a routing protocols. Okay, router OSPF. Okay, process ID 1. Let's declare the directly connected network of our router. That is the 10.10.10.0.0.0.0.3 wildcard mask under area 0. Then we will declare the network 192.168.10.0 network under wildcard mask of 000255 for the reverse address of the subnet mask. Okay, area 0. Okay, since there's still no router on the leftmost connectivity, so let's make it passive. So to reduce the processing power of your router, the other side is not required to receive the routing advertisement. Okay, exit, then do p run start to save the configuration. About here, okay, router 2, router OSP process ID 1. Okay, next is declare the network. Let's declare 10 network, 10, yeah, 172.16.10.0.0.0.0.255. Okay, under area 0. Okay, declare the other network so that there can be an adjacency. So once I place this, the router will exchange next passive interface. Okay, that's what I'm talking. Okay, passive interface, the G0/0/0, so that they will not receive the broadcast advertisement. Okay, since we already configured the router with the routing protocols, we can now communicate to the remote network. Let's test. Let's ping 192.168.10.1 from router here to here. So yes, there will be a success. Okay, to copy, run, start. So we have successfully configured now the required. Okay, so if you're using the PC example, you want to see there's a connectivity from PC2 to PC0, PC1. So let's typing. Okay, 192.168.10.1. Okay, it's applying. Okay, about 2. Okay, time out. Okay, okay, then 250 for the network controller. Okay, it's now activated. Okay, we have this PC1. Can we now move on to the browser? 172.168.10.0. 172. 16, dot 10, dot 250. Okay, we can now access from PC1 here to the server. Okay, the web server activated. Now moving on. What will be the purpose of this network controller? Okay, so using your PC1, let's configure the network controller to capture information from the network devices. The address of the network controller is 10.250. Okay, go. There you go. We now place an admin example. I want to use the same network user password. Admin is it as Cisco. Then verification Cisco setup. Okay, let's place admin. Then Cisco. Let's log in. Yes, there you go. We can now log in on the network controller. Okay, as you can see, the network controller does haven't yet captured any devices and hosts on a specific network. So let's move on to the provisioning. Okay, we want to add credentials. Okay, that the credentials are the created username and password from your secure shell. Okay, let's add a user. Okay, we have used the admin and Cisco on our router and switches password. Okay, that's it. Next, how about network discovery? So by default, the CDP. What do I mean? Okay. If you are not running a CDP, you can enable it. Cisco configure terminal. Just CDP run if you want to turn on. I know it is by default turn on, just to make sure CDP running, so that there will be a Cisco discovery protocol CDP running. Okay, about here, enable Cisco. Okay, then configure terminal. I just want to ensure that the CDP protocol is running. But of course, no, as a network administrator, it is not advisable to turn on the Cisco discovery protocol. There's so many hackers software right now. Okay, going back to the network. 2.168.10.250. Okay, I just want to go back in the configuration admin, then Cisco login. Okay, this will be the network devices. It's not yet captured. Move on to the provisioning. I want to discover. Okay, let's place a network discovery here. Okay, if you want to look for the router one example, okay, we know that the router one is 192.168.10.254. Okay, we will be using the credential admin as its SSH user and password. Add. Okay, it will discover the information on the router. Now waiting. discovery. How about switch? What if I'm looking for the switch 1 with a starting address of 192.168.10.1 until the last IP address 192.168.10.254. The credential of admin. Complete. The router 1 has been discovered by the network controller. As you can see here, the network controller SIM I've been seen the switch 1 to switch 2 and router 1 because of credentials. How about the host? How about the discovery? To discover a just an example switch to on the other 172.16.10.1 until 172.16.10.254. Okay. Although it's already seen, I just want to test. So this will be our network devices. Let's move on the dashboard. Okay, as you can see on the dashboard, okay, we've seen 6 devices that will be the probably the switch and router. Okay, so host devices we have 4, although we have a 6. Oh, do we have 6 host devices? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, we have 5 devices. Of course, 4 devices because it's not include the network devices. That is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, it's already complete. Okay, now let's move on to the Python. Okay, okay, let's save this. Using the Python, okay. We're moving on the Python code. Okay. Let's open a Python reward. About Python 3, I want to create new file. Okay. Let's get a best ticket from this one. Okay, I want to tell you something. Since you are using the this is also important, so that you will know the variable required inside the network controller. Okay, discover something that will be helpful for you, for the instructor as well as for the student. Cisco. Okay, I just want to point out here that on the API docs, okay, this will be the network devices. Okay, as you can see, these are the commands that you can use on the curl, but in this case is I want to get host. Okay, so if you're getting host, you can see here the API B1 host. Okay, then the requirement. Okay, the requirement for that host will be, this will be the name of query parameters that you can use. At the same time, if you are getting for the variable needed for the network devices, about this one, okay, ensure that you are on the PIB1 network devices. Okay. Okay. Then, requirement for the variables that you can use. Where is network devices by IP example. Want to know where we gonna get the variable that's required. Okay, let's move on. We'll show it later, like this one. Okay. Okay, let's this code, the script code, paste here. Okay, as you can see, I've used the okay, we will be using admin here as a credential, and the password will be the place it as a Cisco. That's why we have created that. And that's what I'm talking. Okay, we are on the ticket, on the packet tracer. If we are on moving on the ticket, so this will be the string required. There you go, the API/B1/ticket. That's why we are here. Okay. Execute that. Let's run. We need to save it. Let's say this is ticket. Execute. There you go. We have the service ticket number captured here. Let's copy this one. Okay. That's good, no? That means that the Python from the real world can now communicate inside the network controller using the port 5800. Okay, so we are placing 58,000. Okay, we've already captured the code. Oh, let me place here the service ticket code. Okay, next is what if? Okay, save that. Let's create new. If I want to get information, okay. Let's copy this one and paste. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh yes, Control B. Okay, let's save this one. Run. Run, okay, and the name is host. Host. Save. Question: is it? Oh, there's an error. Why? We need to place our service ticket here. That's why I told you to copy paste it. Okay, get the ticket, place it here. Okay, Control B. There you go. Then save, then run. There you go. Okay, I've seen response that we are requiring the name. Okay, of the host, then the host IP, this is the host name, the host IP, then the MAC address, and the port. Okay, connected interface name. So if you are using this one, okay, we are looking for the host. Okay, as you can see on the host, the variable here, host name, host MAC, are the same variable used in the Python code. Okay, you've seen the host name, so check. They are case sensitive. Okay, the host IP there. Okay, in this example from the host, we just want to capture the host name, then the host IP, okay, the host MAC address, okay, MAC address, and the host connected interface. Okay, this will be your guide on the process. Okay, how about the network? We've already through here. Let's get the network device. Okay, Control C, next we need to create new file, and Control V, ensure that our host ticket are placed. Okay, copy the host ticket, place it here. Okay, paste. Oops, it's not deleted. Okay, okay, there you go. Okay, okay, run. Okay, let's save it first. Let's say the name is network. Okay, network device. Save, then execute. There you go. We have already captured that status, the MAC address, okay, as well as the network device IP address and the network device platform. Okay, there you go. It's working. Okay, so to make sure, okay, that you are on the right path, okay, you can also get information from this API. That is a useful network device, this one. That's why you are on the API B1 network device. Okay, as you can see here, you are on the API network device. Then, okay, what's the information? This is just the parameter. Count IP address. Okay, it's good. Okay. Host inventory. Where did I copy that? Copy that from this get. Add network, get network. Okay, what are the parameters I'm telling? This one, if you are on the API network device, you can also use the global credential IP ID or the IP address to get information. Okay, for as long as they are on the same path. Okay, for the host IP address. Okay, this will be the we already used that on the getting host. I'm looking for the copied it from this. I just forgot where did I copy it. Network device. For as long as you are on the same network device, you can see the required required parameter name. Okay. But that's why I just get that information, that parameter given in this API. Okay, that will be the activity. So yeah, as you can see, that's good. Okay, that the Python can communicate on your packet tracer. Okay, you can use this activity, okay, to ensure that your DevNet course will serve this one as a activity outcome for your student. Okay, thank you.